thank you very much to Professor Bob Jerram for giving us an interview here at the Central European meeting of the EAU, where you are the chair of the EAU regional office. And first I would like to ask you to tell us a few words about this meeting. How many attendees are visiting it, from which countries, and why is it worth participating here?
So thank you very much. The regional office and the European Association of Urology are organizing since many years regional meetings. One of the main goals of these regional meetings is to allow a platform for regional countries which have different pathologies, different medical interests, to exchange between each other their medical, scientific and clinical knowledge, B, to encourage the exchange of science in between these countries as well. So not only to present, but actually to allow bridging of these different countries, which is outside politics and outside national interests, that is really pure for the benefit of our patients. It also allows local training and local fellowship programs to be encouraged. But besides that, it's a very important scientific stimulus for the regions. And remember that most of the new developments in medicine back 100, 150 years ago came from these regions. And of course, now this has switched for many reasons, maybe to the US and to the Western European countries, although the historical roots of all these developments were actually here. So it's kind of nice to come back here. But it's also important to allow these countries and specifically the young colleagues, to have a platform where they present themselves, where they show themselves, show their work, which probably in bigger meetings would not be that easy for time and space reasons. And so this is a first step for a young colleague to go into the international arena, and from there to probably move to another career that maybe would not be possible if he just stays in his department and does not show himself. So from that perspective, I think that the EAU Regional Office has achieved some of its goals, and we're very, very proud and happy that so many colleagues from around the region have come. And this was the same last year and the year before, and hopefully next year in Vienna will be even more successful. We have roughly, I think, close to 400, including faculty here. And 400 urologists for this 7-8 countries is very impressive, because these are really the opinion leaders of urology in Central Europe. The attractiveness of this meeting is also seen by the fact that 60 abstracts, for example, were submitted from outside Europe. So you have up to Kazakhstan, down to Asian countries who have submitted and participated in this meeting. But more importantly, you have the Secretary General of the EAU, Professor Chris Chappell. You have guests from the U.S., the chairman of NYU, New York University, the Urology Department, Professor Lepore. You have European key opinion leaders, you know, like Professor Janicek and others, all are here. And I think it's extremely important that this bridging and this connection between these colleagues function to the benefit, A, of the patient, and B, to the benefit of the young colleagues. Because remember that this generation of key opinion leaders that we have now, in 10 years or 15 years, they are gone. And we should not allow the building of a gap between the next generation. So besides our emotional, personal, and political, I would say, disagreements, it should be one common sense, is to work with each other and to allow urology to advance in the region. And I have to say, in conclusion, if you look at the past 5-6 years, the level of science, just by looking at the abstracts here, has increased tremendously. We had by far not as many good abstracts in terms of quantity and quality back 10 years ago. So it's we can literally feel the improvement.
Which are the topics that are in the focus of interest in this year's meeting?
Well, in urology, and this has obvious reasons, oncology is always one of the leaders, but functional urology is coming a lot. So there is a lot of interest in functional urology, in uro-oncology, andrology, of course, stone disease, infectious disease. This meeting, one of the important parts of this meeting was actually the infectious disease part, the guidelines committee, the European guidelines from the EAU on infectious disease. We had just a meeting here during this meeting. So there were different aspects really that were covered, and also techniques, new technologies, new equipment. So we have here just many different possibilities of doing hands-on training, so that young colleagues can come and in a few days learn actually with models, with maquettes, to train and be trained in new technologies available in urology. So really the level of interest is very wide.
Today you chaired one of the uro-oncology sessions. If you have to pick up one or two very important take-home messages, what would be that?
Well, number one is that we need to focus more on imaging. I think imaging is a very important part, and multiparametric MRI has replaced the simple finger in the PSA test. They still are very important, but in conjunction with the multiparametric MRI. The second thing that is very important to remember is that you need to look at new markers. We cannot just rely on PSA. There's a lot of genetic markers, Polaris, GPS test, the Decipher test, that are available and commercially available, and they are indeed helping increase and improve the detection of prostate cancer, most importantly the aggressive prostate cancers. And finally, I think overall, if you look at all the biopsy techniques out there, we don't do biopsies blindly anymore. We do what we call targeted biopsies. And I think that if you look at all the technologies available, the imaging, the new markers, I think that the way we diagnose prostate cancer has changed. 20 years ago is just find any cancer. And today we want to find really the bad cancers. And we want to find them as with the least amount of complications as possible and with the most efficacious way as possible. And this is what we are aiming at. Yeah.